In this video, we're calculating the magnetic field at the center of a rotating, uniformly charged ring. So in the diagram, we see our rotating ring with radius big R, total charge big Q, and angular speed omega. Now the point of this problem is to exploit a previous solution in which we found the magnetic field at the center of a current loop using the Biot-Savart Law. And I'll post a link to that video at the top real quick, but the conclusion was that the magnetic field at the center of a current loop has a magnitude of mu naught I over 2R. And we can also see the direction of that field in the diagram, with B pointing out of the page, corresponding to the counterclockwise rotation of the positive charge on this ring. So the whole idea of the problem here is that for some fixed observation point along the edge of the ring, a constant amount of charge is going to pass by that observation point every time 1 second goes by. And that charge per second is exactly the same thing as a current passing by the observation point. So if we can calculate the current resulting from the charged rotating ring, then we just plug into our previous result that we got from the Biot-Savart Law, and we've got the magnetic field. Now, before I start writing anything else down, my preference is to introduce the idea of linear charge density as we do this calculation. So the linear charge density, notated by a lowercase lambda here, is the charge per unit length, or Q divided by L, and that has units of coulombs per meter. And this means we can always find the total charge contained in a length L by turning that around as Q equals lambda times L. In other words, if you take the coulombs per meter and you multiply by meters, you get coulombs. So what we're going to do now is allow a small time increment of dt to go by, and some charge is going to pass that observation point on the ring. So in that time of little dt, the edge of the ring traces out a small arc that we call ds, and that arc subtends an angle of d theta. So now we can apply our old formula from geometry, s equals r theta for the arc length. But for this context, it's ds that's equal to r d theta. Next, we can find the charge contained in that little arc increment by just multiplying that length ds by the linear charge density lambda. So remember back here in our linear charge density formula, we can always get charge by taking linear charge density times length. So we end up with lambda ds, which is actually the charge that passed by that observation point, is equal to lambda r d theta. So another name for that lambda ds, the amount of charge that passes the observation point in this infinitesimal amount of time, is dq, an infinitesimal amount of charge. So we arrive at this expression, dq is lambda r d theta. Now we're going to divide both sides by dt, and the whole point of that is that on the left-hand side we get dq over dt, which is the rate at which charge is passing that point, in other words, the current. On the right-hand side, we end up with lambda r d theta dt, which is the rate of change in angle, in other words, omega. So plugging in the current for dq dt, we have I, and then plugging in omega for d theta dt, on our right-hand side, we have a lambda r omega. So finally, we can plug this into our previous result for the magnetic field. And we find that our magnetic field at the center of this rotating ring is given by mu naught times I, well, that's lambda r omega, over 2r. And of course, those r's are going to cancel out. And we end up with a result of mu naught lambda omega over 2. Now, that can be a useful way to represent our answer, so I went ahead and put a box around it. But the way our problem was given to us in this video is that we were given the total charge on the ring, capital Q, so we should write our final answer in terms of that capital Q instead of lambda. But lambda is just the total charge on the ring divided by the total length of this ring, in other words, the circumference. So that's Q divided by 2 pi big R. So if we replace the lambda in our expression for magnetic field with Q over 2 pi R, we're going to get mu naught Q omega over 4 pi R. And that's our final answer. In the next video, we're going to use this result to compute the magnetic field at the center of a rotating, uniformly charged disk. I'll post a link to that video at the upper left of the end screen, and I'll see you there.